Warning. The warning on this video has been removed. And as always, for YouTube, this video is highly educational. And in this video, we will learn a lesson about the consequences of missing one redback spider nest and how important my flamethrower method is in controlling these deadly spiders. And it has been 10 weeks since my last redback spider roundup. Okay, warm up the flamethrower. Let's do it.
It is finally raining. The rain has come and broken the drought at our place, so guess what's going to happen now? It's very simple and very effective. Good night, sister.
Yeah!
Oh yeah, them redback spideys that were sitting up here. Guess what? Now no longer. I can burn the place out.
Slow motion, baby! Hell yeah! Good night, sister!
It's been 5 months that I've had to wait for this time. It has been incredibly dry, but the spiders are getting sorted out! I just hope Mummy doesn't see this video or else I'm in stacks of trouble!
Woo! Oopsie doopsie, a little bit too much heat on that one! I'm sure I saw Red back in there. Well, I don't see him anymore! This is another favourite haunt that I can hit with a little bit of fire. Just a little bit. Woo-hoo! It can be delicate work at times. Just a little blab will do it. And I know they love being up there. Oh yeah. That shows you how much rain we've had in a very short time. I love it. Another favourite haunt for them little spideys. Yeah. Unbelievably satisfying to be able to get round to do this. You just gotta be thorough. Yeah. Smoking. I mean, look at that in there. There's actually an egg sac there and there's a redback web. I got the perfect solution. Good night, little sister. Dusted. Yeah.
Oh, the poor little redback spot egg sac all burned up and frittered. I'll give that dome a bit more flame. I'm worried there's another redback in there.
Yeah! It really does take out them redbacks. It's a wonderful process. As long as you're careful. Just doing some delicate work here. So you can see that I'm not a total animal. So nice to see water running through the backyard, and I can come into this area here, and it's been a problem zone in the past. A few little blocks of fire, dusted. There's this new zone that Mummy made up the back here. I'm not seeing web, but there might be baby spiders just starting to set up. So I can come along and just very quickly do gentle blaps. Yeah. I'll come in and get the reverse of this area here. There's what's living in there, well it's not living now. A little in between areas like that, there. See the way the fire goes all the way up? Yeah, I'm really catching up with some stuff that should have been done months ago. There's a spot there that I don't want to hit, but I do want to get around the pots next to it. And I can be very, very select and where I put my crazy flame. Just so satisfying. Now spiders like to lurk in wheelbarrows and places like this. Oh crikey, a pair of Mummy's gloves. How many times have I told them don't leave them out in the garden? They're probably spider infested. I'll deal with those in a second. I'll just check underneath this wheelbarrow. I can see a little bit of spider activity, and often little spider activity leads to big spider activity. I'm just gonna carefully flick this over. You never know what you're gonna find inside. Oh crikey, Charlie, that's a massive one! Only way to deal with a big spider is a freaking big flame! Good night, big sister. Nasty one, indeed. I think that spider's from a family called the wire spiders. Really dangerous in Australia, and they're sort of associated with drop bears. Horrible things.
Anyway, dusted. Oh, let's not forget Mummy's gloves. They're spider infested. I'll put it over with that wire spider. Yeah, another spider problem sorted out in a big way. I do keep reminding you, Australia's not for everyone. Anyway, I think Mummy's gloves are toast. At least there's no spiders in them now. And you thought I forgot about the spideys under there? Well, I didn't. Guess what? That's it. I love the smell of hot wheelbarrow in the morning. I honestly thought it was never going to rain again. Look at the grass, it's looking very drab, isn't it? That's the way I deal with redback spider infestations at my place. The idea is to get to those nesting areas before the egg sacs open up. And in fact, I did find a nesting area, and we'll just have a quick look at the egg sacs before this video is over, because we need to be educational, because this is YouTube. Well, I did find that nest area. Look at that, 4 redback spider egg sacs. I did find the female redback spider. That is a little bit too advanced for my liking. What I'll do before I look at this is we'll take a look at my redback spider control chart. This is an important document to help me understand redback spiders and help you understand my methods. At the moment, I'm shooting this video basically mid-January. The rain has finally come. We basically had all these months here with no rain, a lot of bad fires in Australia, blah, blah, blah. What was very curious was just before this moment here, I noticed in the suburb lots of ants building up ant mounds around the ant nest. Now, there was a huge argument. People say this is a sign of rain coming, although scientists will say there's no correlation at all. But I'm sure my audience can answer that very curious ant and rain query. So just thinking about the middle of January here, you look down here, we're right in the middle of peak spider season. And what I classify the start of it is around Halloween. That's what the H is for. And all these burns I couldn't do, I finally got a burn in here. But before the spider season is out, I've got to get a couple of extra burns in to try and clean up the backyard for next spider season. I like this burning method because it's chemical free. I can be very careful and directional and get the spider nests in a safe way. I can also clean up any of these smaller spiderlings that are getting about. And best of all, the things that I've picked up after burning, I can feed that stuff to the ants, and we all love ants. Okay, those redback spider egg sacs are going to teach me something about how long the spider nest was there for. I've got a clean cutting sheet. Let me just set this up and we're going to learn something interesting, I hope. Okay, quite a troublesome load going on here. I have got one egg sac here that got opened up by the flamethrower. The eggs that came out of that are just like little seeds. There's no legs growing from them yet, but it's these three other egg sacs that we're going to have to investigate to see what that spider nest was up to. The egg sac I'll take a look at first is this one here. It's a little bit burnt, and I'll work across in that direction. To condense some time in the video, let me talk over this part here and you can watch what goes on. I'm using the scalpel and tweezers to get into the very tough redback spider egg sacs. Unfortunately, all three presented as empty. Now, that's saying to me, okay, the spiders are out, so let's track back in time. It takes about 4 to 6 weeks for an egg sac to develop spiderlings, and a female redback spider in a good season can lay up maybe 4 or 5 egg sacs, and you're looking at like 1,000 spiderlings generated from one female redback spider in one spider season. And I always call that my scary redback spider math. This redback spider nest was very concealed. It was up in the handle of a black flower pot. That's a very common thing to find. And I did carefully look at this area, but it was way back on the 10th of November of 2019. Let's call it 10 weeks ago. And maybe the nest was there and the web wasn't presenting, but I didn't see egg sacs hanging there. But mind you, if the nest is up inside one of those handles to a pot, well, I'm never going to see it if I don't spot the web. But to get to my point here, that redback spider Roundup back on the 10th of November was only using that scraping monkey tool that I've got a piece of wire, because I'm looking for web and then I'm dragging it through to pull spiders out. The flamethrower does a totally different job. It takes out everything and it's extremely thorough. Let's just say if I wasn't up against the total fire bans, and I could have used the flamethrower back on the 10th of November, this redback spider nest, which presents to me with the empty redback spider egg sacs, would have been easily taken out well before these egg sacs had any opportunity of being developed. But I can't go back and change the course of history. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of redback spiderlings are out in the garden.
Well, this is basically a disaster for me. I've got 3 redback spider sacs. It looks like the redbacks have developed and, well, done their thing. They're all through the garden. I've got 1 sac that I got to here, which had the little spider eggs. You can just see them there attached to that sac. And yes, it's going to set up for a very interesting future of more redback spiders in the backyard. As for this redback spider, it could possibly be a couple of years old. You can see the red markings on its back there. Thank goodness it got that, because you can see them a bit easier in dark places. Yes, I've seen them bigger than this, and people often ask me, you know, what are they like when you cut them open? Well, they usually become quite messy. They are fairly hydraulic in a sense. You press their backs, or this one's opened up the back, but their legs will often move. But there's basically nothing much you can tell from opening them up like this. I think the trick is to basically let them dry out, then you can do a dissection and see stuff, but they just become messy. Oh, actually, maybe you can see there was another egg sac developing there. Let me see if I can just go closer in on that. That's sort of curious. I'm as close as my iPhone is going to let me. I think those white things there was basically going to be another egg sac. I hope I'm correct there. That is quite interesting indeed, because most times when I look in the back of these spiders, there really isn't that much to see. So yes, that would have been her 5th egg sac. Wow, she was quite an awesome girl, wasn't she? Look, part of it's sort of sad, but they are not nice spiders to have in the garden. They are a really dangerous, deadly Australian spider. It wasn't the redback spider's lucky day. Because I didn't use insecticide, I can pick all this up and I can put it in this troublesome truck and I can take it out to the ants. That is, if I can get it unsticky from there. Blech. Well, I know there's an ant colony underneath that pot there. Because it's been raining so much, it looks like they're taking their eggs to a higher place. I think the best bet for me is to basically put this up in the pot plant here, and I'm pretty sure the ants are going to find it. They're going to love me forever. In very little time, look at that. The ants have found that wonderful redback spider. What a fantastic feast for the ant colony. I'm sort of thinking I better hide some nasty evidence that I've got here. If Mummy sees this, I am as fried as that pot there. I better hide it. Hopefully put in the bin and she won't find it. And to cover up that very obvious space there, I'll just drag these forward. Luckily, Mummy doesn't watch my videos because she thinks they're boring. Look at that, you'd never know, and please don't tell her. And to cover up the perfect crime, I've got to hide that pot plant. Mummy hates coming to this because there's always bugs and critters in here. She thinks there's rats down here. Okay, so if I put that in here like that, I better not put the plastic in there, else I'll be in more trouble. I've got to hide this plastic next. That's sort of recycling, isn't it? We're good little recyclers at our place, aren't we? Crikeys, I've got to get rid of that. Pretty obvious, isn't it? I'm sort of thinking yellow bin. It's recyclable, isn't it, that thing? If I hide it in here, Mummy's never going to know. And I think the trick is you sort of cover it up with other stuff and that way I won't get into trouble. Just please don't tell Mummy. Oh, Mummy's just come home. She's looking around the backyard. I hope she doesn't notice what I've done.